On Easter Sunday morning, Anne and I decided to go for a walk across Wythop Moss. We were hoping to hear the sound of skylarks. And we did hear and see skylarks. But the thing which really struck us was, between the songs, total silence. No murmur of traffic from the A66. Even the wind had died away to nothing. The thing about silence is that it can be quite evocative, and it can also be quite intimidating. I know when I'm writing prayers of intercession, I need to put in silences, but make them too short and it sounds like a shopping list. Make them too long and we feel as a congregation uncomfortable. On the 22nd of November 1963, there was an event which rocked the world. The President of the United States, John F. Kennedy, was assassinated. It was an event which left Americans traumatized. But one young American had his response by going into a silent room, dark, lit by a single candle, and he composed a song. The young American was Paul Simon, and the song which he composed was this one. Hello darkness, my old friend, I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walk alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, the halo of a street lamp. I turn my collar to the cold and damp, when my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence. In the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more, people talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share. No one dare disturb the sound of silence. Fools that I do not know, silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you, take my arms that I might reach you, but my words like silent raindrops fell and echoed in the well. And the people bowed and prayed to the neon god they made, and the sign flashed out its warning in the words that it was forming, and the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls and tenement halls. Sound of silence.